Good morning, Standard 9 students. I made you draw a television set. I wanted to see the enthusiasm, the zeal about you watching television, and it seems most of you did enjoy drawing a television set. And I told you to draw a television set mentioning the name of the company or the product and your favorite TV show or your favorite TV channel. Okay. And some of you did a wonderful job, drew, and it was very exciting to see that, you know, Jiffy, you were able to draw a television set and show it. Okay. But the poetry that I'm going to teach you is Television by Rohal Dahl. Or Deha. Okay. Now, he is totally against children watching television. So, it is a very serious matter which he explains in a humorous manner. Humorous means in a funny way. Now, in the course of the poetry, you will come to know what he meant. Now, the irony of this, like you were very excited about drawing a television set, writing the name of your favorite show, or writing the name of your favorite channel. But the irony is that this poet is discouraging the parents to not to allow the children to be near the television set, and even not to install a television set in your house. Now, when a television set comes to the house, everyone is very excited to watch certain programs. Okay. And many children are addicted to television, parents. Now, television was actually launched in India in the year 1980. Now, when you were born, perhaps your parents may have already installed a television set. You must have seen a big object in your house, and then you came to know that mommy, papa, they keep watching television. Okay. Now, there is a lot of happiness in a family when a television set is newly bought and brought to the house. During our time, whosoever installed a television set, they had to install an antenna and the roof of their house, a long pole would be inserted and the antenna would be there to get the signals. And then every time you have to keep turning and twisting, one will be on top, one will be near the television shouting, "Aya ki nahi aya, aya ki nahi aya." So those were all fun those days. But now science has improved to such a great extent that now we are carrying the television in our hands through the mobile phone. What we used to observe or see on television, now we can see it in our mobile phones. So that is the advancement of science and technology. It's so good. But how dangerous it is for children, that is what the poet is now advising the parents. So I'll read and explain. Okay. The most important thing we've learned means the parents have learned, so far as children are concerned, so where the children are concerned, are in question, is never, never, never let them hear your television set. It says never allow your children to be near the television set. Or better still, just don't install the idiotic thing at all. Says for better advice, he says don't allow them to sit near the television set. Better still, he says don't have this idiotic thing at all in your house. He says don't install this television set in your house. And he calls it an idiotic thing, an idiot box, for which children are addicted to. Now why he is saying this? In almost every house we've been, we've watched them gaping at the screen. He says for every house we've been visiting, we have noticed that the children have got their eyes fixed onto the TV. They will not budge a little. They will not look right, no, left. We watch them gaping at the screen. They loll and slop and lounge about. Now in their sitting posture, sometimes on the sofa set, they are half reclined, half they are lying down and watching television. Their postures may be different. They keep switching over their positions. Okay. But in a very lazily manner. Like in class, we tell you sit upright. They don't watch television that way. They watch television in a very casual, half-asleep manner. Okay. Which is not a good sign for a young child to sit awkwardly or in a wrong posture. And stare until their eyes pop out. They keep staring into the television as if the eyes are going to come off from the socket. Last week in someone's place, we saw a dozen eyeballs on the floor. So last week when we went to someone's house, there we noticed a dozen of eyeballs on the floor. Now this is a height of exaggeration. Now we don't expect that the eyeballs should leave our socket and come and start dancing on the floor along with the program. What it means that they continuously keep watching television for long hours, which is a big strain in the eyes. Okay. So that is the height of exaggeration. The poet is exaggerating. He's gone a little beyond our staring, gaping, but eyeballs popping out, eyeballs on the floor. That is ridiculous. But he is just expressing how much television children watch for long, long hours. So that is the fear. That is why he said, I've seen eyeballs on the floor. It means that children have watched television practically the whole night. But he has exaggerated. He has spoke a little more by saying that the eyeballs were found on the floor. Now this kind of exaggeration, the literary device used, or it is called a hyperbole. Okay. H-Y-P-E-R. Hyperbole means it is a exaggeration. Now, for example, now what do you mean by exaggeration? When people, what they say in Hindi, bhanjta hai. When they start bhanjoing, ki mera papa ka paas 10 hawai jahaz hai, 15 go pani jahaz hai. When he doesn't even own a car, but he is exaggerating. Okay, so that is the meaning. Now, this term is called a hyperbole when somebody exaggerates. So this is the literary device that is used. They sit and stare. And stare and sit. Until they are hypnotized by it. Now they are hypnotized means as if the television has casted a magical spell on them. Now this is the addiction of television, of watching television. Okay. Now a magician, he hypnotizes. A psychiatrist uses hypnotism to find out the inner truth which man cannot express when he is conscious. In his consciousness, he is not able to express. So these psychiatrists, magicians, they use the power of hypnotism. Okay. And the television set has casted a magical spell on them, as if they are now attracted towards the television. Until they are absolutely drunk. Means what they say in a TV ka nasha. So like that, he says they get drunk watching and watching. It's not, the drunkenness is not due to intoxication. It is the addiction towards watching television with all that shocking, ghastly junk. With all that shocking, ghastly junk means all the nonsense, all the kind of programs which are not meant for children are also shown, and children, they get attracted towards it. Okay. So some of these, they show whether it is meant for children or not. I'll keep it till here. Okay. Then tomorrow I shall continue the same poetry, and wish you all the best, and be aware of watching television too much. Thank you.